Good morning. Welcome to St. Nicholas Parish Community as we gather to celebrate the seventh Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our gathering song is number 549, All Creatures of Our God and King, number 549. Please stand and welcome the people around you. Creatures of our God and King, lift up your voices, let us sing. Alleluia, alleluia. Bright burning sun with golden beams, soft silver moon that gently gleams. Oh, praise Him. Oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Great rushing winds who are so strong, you clouds above that sail along. Oh, praise Him. Rejoice, stars nightly shining, find a voice. Oh, praise Him, oh, praise Him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers, sisters, that we might worthily offer the sacred mysteries, as always we prepare by acknowledging our need and expressing our longing for God's forgiveness and peace. Your holy death, O Lord, we remember. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Your glorious resurrection, we proclaim. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your coming in glory, we await. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. You alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that always pondering spiritual things, we may carry out, both in word and action, that which is pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Do we have a reader? My sister always comes through.
Thank you. A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to the whole Israelite community and tell them, 'Be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy. You shall not bear hatred for your brother or sister in your heart. Though you may have to reprove your fellow citizen, do not incur sin because of him. Take no revenge and cherish no grudge against any of your people. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. I am the Lord." The word of the Lord.
The Lord is kind and merciful. The Lord is kind and merciful. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. The Lord is kind and merciful. He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills. He redeems your life from destruction, crowns you with kindness and compassion. The Lord is kind and merciful. Merciful and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger and abounding in kindness. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes. The Lord is kind and merciful. As far as the east is from the west, so far has he put our transgressions from us. As a father has compassion on his children, so the Lord has compassion on those who fear him. The Lord is kind and merciful.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that you are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy that person, for the temple of God, which you are, is holy. Let no one deceive himself. If anyone among you considers himself wise in this age, let him become a fool so as to become wise. For the wisdom of this world is foolishness in the eyes of God. For it is written, God catches the wise in their own ruses. And again, the Lord knows the thoughts of the wise, that they are vain. So let no one boast about human beings, for everything belongs to you. Paul or Apollos or Cephas or the world or life or death, or the present or the future, All belong to you, and you to Christ, and Christ to God. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, offer no resistance to one who is evil. When someone strikes you on the right cheek, turn the other one as well. If anyone wants to go to law with you over your tunic, hand over your cloak as well. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go 2 miles. Give to the one who asks of you, and do not turn your back on someone who wants to borrow. You have heard that it was said, you shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father. For he makes his sun rise on the bad and on the good, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers only, what's unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So, be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning. Sometimes, kind of perhaps unusual or surprising or interesting conversations break out. For example, after Mass one day, we were up at the North Campus and there was a small group of people gathered after 12:10 Mass and they were talking. I came down and all I heard was, "Yeah, it is terrible." And of course, being newsy, I said, "Oh, what's so terrible?" Now, being terrible, it could be that it's too hot, it's too cold. Terrible is a relative word, huh? Well, I said, "Well, what's so terrible?" And they said, "The war in Ukraine." Now, I think we can all agree that that is a terrible reality. Well, somebody in the group said, "Well, you know what I think they should do? Of course, we all have plans for world peace, don't we? It's very nice when we're standing in a nice, warm, heated place with nobody. We all know how to end the war, right?" Mm-hmm. Well, this person's opinion, and maybe some of you have heard it or maybe share it, she says, I pray that more and more countries will impose sanctions
Are you following this? That more and more countries will impose sanctions so that more and more people will get upset and Putin will have to resign and the war will be over. I don't know. Somebody else said, now this is the surprising part. She asked the question, well, you know what? Do you ever pray for President Putin? Now, probably that has hit a nerve with most people. How can we pray for that man? I'll leave the adjectives out. She said, I'll never pray for that demon. And maybe we agree with that, right? Maybe we agree with that. But yet somebody in the group says, but you know what? Maybe if we pray for him, maybe somehow something might finally sink in. He might come to his senses. He might admit his not sane actions and begin to chart another course. Maybe that's possible. Now, we might say immediately, no, that's not possible. But are we people who believe in the power of prayer, huh? Pray for our enemies, right? There was one of our earlier presidents. I'm not sure. I think it might be Thomas Jefferson. Maybe a historian can correct me after Mass. I think it was Thomas Jefferson. And what he did was to go through the Gospels, okay? And he cut out anything that had to do with miracles, okay? Anything that was out of the ordinary. I think he kind of looked at the gospel as kind of a way to come to good living through basically the gift of reason and rationality. So we don't need anything coming from out there. Jesus gives us how to live right here. We don't need any miracles, huh? Cut them out. It struck me that maybe some of us might say, let the miracles in, we need the miracles. But cut out some of the other sayings that come out of Jesus' mouth. Like, for example, Matthew chapter 5, 38 to 48. The section of the gospel that we just heard, huh? Way back, 2001, my friend Lamont and I, we had planned a trip. We were going to head to Washington, D.C. on September 12th. We remember what happened on the 11th. But we were still going. We had the trip planned. And our mom, you know, oh, you can't go. You can't go. And I said, Mother, Washington, D.C. is going to be the safest place on the face of the earth. We went. And then we went to Mass in the morning at the National Shrine. We saw Monsignor Rossi. And you'll never guess what the gospel reading was for that day. The very same one that we just heard proclaimed this morning. Pray, love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you. And if there was any day that maybe some of us wanted to rip that page out of the gospel, that might have been it. Sometimes, sisters and brothers, you know, we look at the gospel and we hear one line, you know, many of our God-fearing Christian brothers and sisters, they'll say, they'll quote this section of the gospel. You've heard it said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. There it is, right in the Bible. But, they leave out that little word, but. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Of course, we will all be blind and have no teeth. That little word, Jesus says, but I say to you, love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you. It might seem to go against our nature. And maybe our enemy lives thousands of miles away and we only see him or her on television. Or maybe our enemy lives across the street. You know, when we turn little things into big things, You know, that they never put their garbage cans away after the dump, after the truck comes by, or in the fall, their leaves blow onto our property, or the car in front of us isn't moving fast enough for us. You know how little things can turn into wars in our own hearts and in our own minds. And Jesus says, we have to stop the violence, because violence breeds violence. Hate breeds hate. You punch me, I'm going to punch you back harder. That seems to be the lesson that is taught to us in so many different ways. However, Jesus puts in that little word, but it cannot be like that with us. We who follow his word, we who follow his way. But it is so hard, there's no doubt about that. It is so challenging, there's no doubt about that. It's impossible, that's not true. As we hear in the gospel again and again, all things are possible, huh? Even breaking the cycle of violence and hurt and revenge. There's no doubt about it, it's difficult. But on a lot of the sayings of Jesus in the Bible, what he calls us to do, how he calls us to live, aren't they so very challenging and demanding? But yet we come together and we hear that command of the Lord and it jumps out at us, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. A hard, as some of the people said to Jesus, this is a hard saying. It is. St. Paul reminds us that we are God's dwelling place. We are the temple of God. We have these beautiful buildings that house us, that allow us to come together. We have another beautiful church up on the North Campus. There are great, mighty cathedrals all over the world. People gather together in garages in some places. But St. Paul reminds us that we, the children of God, that we are God's dwelling place. God dwells in the holiness of our lives. And there can't be any room in this temple, for anger or revenge or hatred. That's the word of the Lord. Oh, sisters and brothers, it's so challenging. It's so demanding, the word that Jesus speaks to us. But hopefully we'll remember just who it is that allows us to do those things that we might think impossible, that we've been given the gift of the Holy Spirit, who gives us the strength, who gives us the courage, who gives us the insight, who gives us the determination to do those things that we might otherwise deem just impossibilities. Maybe the Spirit can penetrate our hearts and find there our willingness to hear and live the word, perhaps even enabling us to pray for those who persecute us, to love our enemies. And perhaps we might be very surprised that in doing that, God's Spirit is making us a perfect people, just as our Father in heaven is perfect.
I believe one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray.
Our response today is, Lord, hear our prayer. That Christians everywhere may take Jesus' words to heart, responding to sin with mercy, hurt with charity, and hatred with love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
1 year ago, the war in Ukraine began. For all victims of the war, for peace, we pray always for peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parents, teachers, and catechists, that by word and example they inspire those in their care to love one another and bring conversion to the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who suffer from the hurt of others, may they find the courage to accept the challenge to forgive, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may they find healing and hope in the ministry of their caregivers, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For victims and survivors, for rescue workers and medical personnel, for all affected by the earthquake in Turkey, Syria, and Lebanon, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we remember that we are God's temple, God's dwelling place, we pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, we pray especially for Rufus Williams, for whom this Mass is offered, and for Giuseppe Zaffarana, Mildred Petkovich, and Ruth Gavin. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Hear the prayers of your people, O gracious God, for they are offered as always through Christ our Lord. Amen. Today there'll be a second collection for the church in Eastern Europe. I'm sure we can count on your generosity.
The offertory hymn is number 492. Where charity and love prevail, number 492.
Charity and love prevail, there God is ever found, brought here together by Christ's love, by love are we thus bound. With grateful joy and holy fear, God's charity we with heart and mind and soul, now love God in return. Forgive we now each other's faults, as we our faults confess, and let us love each other well. Christian holiness. Let strife among us be unknown. Let all contention cease. Be God's the glory that we seek. Be ours God's holy peace. Let us recall that in our midst dwells God's begotten Son. As members of his body joined, we are in Christ made one. No race nor creed can love exclude. If honored be God's name, our family embraces all, whose Father is the same.
And now let us pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. As we celebrate your mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer to the honor of your name may profit us for salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And your
lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks now to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For when your children were scattered about by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of your Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed as one by the unity of the Trinity, made the body of Christ, the dwelling place of your Spirit, might, to the praise of your manifold wisdom, be manifested as your church. And so in company with all the angels and saints, we praise you. And with great joy, together we proclaim.
Holy,
holy,
holy.
Blessed
is he who comes.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the earth, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Pope Francis, with our Bishop Joseph and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her beloved Joseph, with the apostles, with Saint Nicholas and Blessed Pauline, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Together, as the Lord Jesus has taught us, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and be safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Lord Jesus, you said to your apostle, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please turn to hymn number 664, Loving and Forgiving, number 664. In kindness, loving and forgiving are you. All my being, bless the Lord, bless the holy name of God. All my being, bless the Lord, remembering the goodness of God. gracious, loving, and forgiving are you. God forgives us all our sins, healing those who live in pain, saving us from final death. God fills us with goodness and love. Loving and forgiving are you, O Lord, slow to anger, rich in kindness. Loving and forgiving are you. Good and gracious is the Lord, slow to anger, rich in love. God remembers not our sins, forgiving and loving is God. Loving and forgiving are you, slow to anger, rich in kindness, loving and forgiving are you. As heaven soars above the earth, so great the love of God for us. As far as east is from the west, the Lord takes our sins from us. Loving and forgiving are you, O Lord, slow to anger, rich in kindness, loving and forgiving are you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, grant that we may experience the effects of the salvation which is pledged to us by these sacred mysteries, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please, as always, I hope you'll take a bulletin. A lot is included. Mother Pauline still has a poinsettia over there, but Wednesday is Ash Wednesday. All the things about Lent and Ash Wednesday are included. The schedule for here and for the North Campus are included. Also, a little handout, everything you've wanted to know about Lent, I hope you'll take that home and share it with somebody. Did you know that pretzels were an important part of Lenten practice at one point? No, you read all about it. Also in the bulletin, the statistics for our parish here and up at the North Campus as well. I hope you'll take those figures. You know, we've looked at our finances in both places. We're looking now at, what's happening here and up the street as well. So I hope you'll read those figures carefully, okay? And I think that's it. The Lord be with you. May God bless you, Father and Son and Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended, go in peace, alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God, alleluia, alleluia.
Kindly remain and turn to hymn number 586. They'll know we are Christians by our love. Number 586.
We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit. We are one in the Lord. And we pray that all unity may one day be restored. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. And they'll know we are Christians by our love. We will walk with each other. We will walk hand in hand. We will walk with each other. We will walk hand in hand. And together we'll spread the news that God is in our land. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love. We will work with each other. We will work side by side. We will work with each other. We will work side by side. And we'll guard each one's dignity and save each one's pride. And they'll know we are Christians by our love, by our love. Yes, they'll know we are Christians by our love.